Let's speak to Edoardo Bressanelli, who's a senior lecturer in European politics at King's College London and joins me now from the Italian city of Pisa. So Giuseppe Conte had some harsh words about Matteo Salvini, but he has stood down as Prime Minister. What do you make of that?
Well, certainly what we'll witness is a quite incredible, powerful and to some extent dramatic speech. Salvini, the Vice President, was sitting, but the Vice Prime Minister was sitting close to Giuseppe Conte. And Giuseppe Conte was delivering a powerful blow against Matteo Salvini. Really, one of the most powerful we've ever seen in Italian politics. At the same time, though, the real question is what's coming next? Because once the two populists have split up, as we've just seen, this break can be somehow resolved, well, the question becomes, what's coming next? Is it possible for any of the two populists, and mainly for the Five Star Movement, ally with someone else in the current Italian parliament? Or are the polls really the only solution for having a strong government capable to deliver it?
So they're the choices, either a new alternative coalition or perhaps new elections. What do you think the likelihood is at this point of Salvini becoming the next Prime Minister?
The situation is very, very fluid. It's not new in Italian politics. Italy is a country which is renowned to be very fluid politically, but in this specific case, really, the odds are spread over a number of scenarios. So, for instance, elections would almost certainly see Salvini becoming Prime Minister, given what the opinion polls are telling us. Elections are more and more unlikely, because all the others know that if elections are called, well, the outcome is almost certain. So all the others want to keep their current power, like the Five Star Movement, or may look at governing positions, like the Democrats. And therefore, there will be another government which is taking over. The question is, will the government be political, or will the government rather be technocratic, as Italy had, for instance, for the last time in 2011, headed by Mario Monti?
What about ordinary Italians? How is this going to affect them, particularly as the question of the budget is yet to be decided?
Yeah, the question of the budget is, of course, a very important one. But what the argument used to not having elections is not a new one. Italy is in a state of recurrent or perpetual crisis. So every time there are upcoming elections, snap elections, of course, the argument is Italy cannot have elections right now because we need to be responsible, because it's not the right moment, the economic crisis, the budget, etc., etc. This may, to some extent, be true, but there is a big risk in this argument. Big risk being that if parties are perceived to be scared of what people may want, and I repeat the point, Matteo Salvini is leading in the polls by quite a big margin, well, technocracy may win now, but ultimately it may drop the confidence for democratic politics in Italy.
Edoardo Bressanelli in Pisa there. Thank you very much indeed for joining us.